दिस इज़ द फर्स्ट क्लास फॉर फाइनल ईयर डिप्लोमा इन इलेक्ट्रिकल एंड इलेक्ट्रॉनिक स्टूडेंट्स फॉर कर्नाटका पॉलिटेक्निक मैंगलोर. सो पावर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स मीन्स कंट्रोलिंग ऑफ पावर बाय इलेक्ट्रॉनिक मीन्स. हियर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स मीन्स यूजिंग सॉलिड स्टेट इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स means semiconductor devices like transistors, diodes, etc. You know, transistors and diodes are part of semiconductor electronics. If the same semiconductor devices are designed to handle very high power, then the same semiconductor devices are called as power semiconductor devices. Means they are going to handle high powers, not signal level. Signal level means you are bothered about waveform shapes, frequency, etc. But power level means you are going to handle or control power, means work, output, load, etc. So power electronics means controlling power by electronic means. Power semiconductor devices consume very much less power, hence the wastage of power is less, so it increases efficiency in electrical transmission, distribution, utilization and everything. You have this printout, so even though the display is not well here, I think you will be able to manage. Now to the next slide. Block diagram of power electronics. So here you have the block, which is power electronic system. So it converts electrical energy from one form into electrical energy in another form. You use power electronic system, and the technique used is control or conversion. The devices, that is power electronic devices, use control and conversion techniques for this. Thank you. So power semiconductor devices, they are classified as mainly power diodes, power transistors, as already said above, and also thyristors. You know diode and transistor. Regarding thyristors, you don't know, which you will study in this subject. Next slide or next point, power semiconductor devices. So you have three qualifications there. Power diodes, there you have three types. Thyristors, you have different types. Power transistors, again you have different types. You have notes with you. And now we will go to the chapter 2, then come back to chapter 1. This is chapter 1, but instead of studying each and every detail of the components, we will first study details of some important components, then study usage or applications of those components, then we will study other components in detail. So go to chapter 2 now. So this is chapter 2. So now we are in chapter 2. Okay, this you know this chapter 2. This is just what is has been explained now. Yes, now we are actually stepping into the subject. From here onwards, you have to be very, very careful. So, SCR, introduction and structure. You can see here, SCR means silicon controlled rectifier. For a semiconductor diode, we can say it is a silicon rectifier or germanium rectifier if it is made from germanium semiconductor. So SCR is made from silicon device or silicon semiconductor, so we call it as a silicon controlled rectifier. Why it is called controlled rectifier, you will understand later. Controlling means you can control the amount of current flowing through the device. Okay, now you will understand the structure. So we can see here it has alternate PN-PN junction. Sorry, PN-PN layers. You have the notes with you, so see that you have PN-PN layers. The outermost P layer is called as anode.